Hi guys, and welcome to the next lesson of this workshop. In this lesson, we are going to show you export of strategies to MetaTrader and also complete settings of MetaTrader 4 so the strategies would trade automatically. You will see how to copy indicators, we will explain parameters, how to run more strategies in the same MetaTrader, and also we will show you where to find logs in MetaTrader in case you would need to contact us because of some bug or problem. Just if you would need our help, we will need these logs. So let's start, and first of all, we will show you how to export the strategies from StrategyQuant. So in StrategyQuant, I have already prepared two strategies that I'm going to export. Basically, you have two options. You can export strategies one by one, or all at once, or more strategies at once. We prefer to export more strategies at once because it's more comfortable. But right now, we are going to start with the first option, and we are going to show you how to export one single strategy. So double click on the strategy they want to export, switch to source code, and in this drop down list, choose the source code type. And in my case, I'm going to choose MetaTrader 4. Also, there is one thing we don't want StrategyQuant to do, and we don't want it to use parameters right now. So it is needed to disable this option. Because otherwise, if you would choose to use variables, the setting of the indicators would be automatically pasted to the trading options. But that is not a preferred choice right now for us. And we do recommend it also to you not to use these parameters. So our choice should be don't use parameters. So just choose this third option from the list. Well, and you can see now the code is much simpler, and now we can export it. But before we start to export the strategy, there is just one thing. StrategyQuant can directly save the magic number into the strategy. So then you have this parameter right in StrategyQuant, and in case you would export the code, this variable would be automatically inscribed in settings, and you don't have to solve anything more later. So I'm gonna set the magic number according to the strategy number, and I'm going to click on save. And the same process goes also for the second strategy. Again, magic number. And write the number of the strategy. Now again, click on the save button, and the strategies are ready for the export. And as you can see, the magic number is already inscribed as variable. And just a quick explanation, what is the magic number? The magic number is a unique number of the strategy that is used for identification of opened trades. In case you would have more open trades in platform, thanks to the magic number, the strategy can recognize which open trade it belongs to. This number is very important when you trade more strategies on one account, and every strategy has to have this magic number or ID. So I hope this is clear now, and let's export the strategies. In case you would export the strategies one by one, you would choose the code. In this concrete case, you would choose MetaTrader 4. And as I already mentioned before, click on Save to File button and just save it somewhere into your computer. Or you can export the strategies all at once. So mark them all or the ones that you want to export. Click on Save, source code, and choose MetaTrader 4. Now just choose the directory where you want to save the exports, confirm it, and click on save. Well, and now the strategies, the exports are ready and prepared. Before we will launch the strategies right in the MetaTrader, we need to set up the MetaTrader so the strategies would trade smoothly. And it means installation of indicators that are not the standard part of the platform. So we need to copy these indicators to our platform. You can find these indicators in the installation folder of StrategyQuant, in folder Custom Indicators, MetaTrader 4, and Indicators. So now switch to MetaTrader, click in the left top corner on File and choose Open Data Folder. Now go to MQL4 folder and to Indicators. Switch back to the StrategyQuant Indicators folder. Select all the indicators using Ctrl A, click on Copy, or use Ctrl plus C. Go back to MetaTrader Indicators folder and click on Paste or use Ctrl plus V. And now all the indicators are here. What I need to do now is to restart the platform so the indicators would be there after the launching, or get these indicators into the platform manually. I'm going to show you the second option. So right click on indicators on the left bottom corner and choose refresh. It may take a while, it depends on your disk speed. So let's wait for a few seconds and you will see the indicators right in the platform. Well, and now the indicators are ready, and let's import there also the strategies. So switch to the folder where you saved your strategies before, select them and copy them. Now get to the MetaTrader folder and choose folder experts where you have to paste the copied strategies. So again, choose paste or use keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus V. And again, right mouse click on expert advisors and choose refresh, just like before with the indicators. And of course, just like before, you can restart the whole MetaTrader. That's the second option that you can use. And like this, our indicators and strategies are ready for launching. Just one thing we have to set up is to allow automated trading. There are two ways again. The first one is just click here on auto trading or go to tools, options, expert advisors. And here you can also set, for example, when the auto trading should be disabled, when the account profile or chart symbol or period has been changed. We do recommend to, for 100%, disable the third option, disable automated trading when the chart symbol or period has been changed, because in such a case there can be a problem and the strategy could trade in absolutely different way. Also, it is good to allow the DLL imports, because if you are going to use, for example, FX Blue, these libraries are necessary for proper functionality of strategies and other trading utilities. So we recommend to allow it and then just click on OK. Well, and right now we are ready to run the strategies. I'm going to prepare charts where I'm going to insert the strategies to. First chart is going to be Euro USD on 15 minutes time frame, and the second one is euro USD on 1 hour time frame. It is needed to mention that if you will run more strategies on one account, you need one chart for each strategy. In MetaTrader, you can run maximally 99 windows, so 99 strategies, but it of course depends on the performance of your virtual server. Let's check if the strategies were successfully imported and it seems that everything is all right. Also, unwrap the strategies and make sure that they are ready. And let's insert our strategies into the charts. I will start with the one on 15 minutes time frame. Again, also here are two options. You can easily just drag and drop the strategy or switch to the concrete window and then double click on the strategy. I choose drag and drop option because it's like more comfortable and like more natural. And now we are going to go through each parameter. Here in settings, you can see trading option parameters, just like we said in StrategyQuant. And in StrategyQuant, if you would check trading options, you would see that these trading options correspond with the settings right in the platform. It always must be the same, because if it wouldn't be the same, strategies would trade differently. So as you can see, it's just the same as we have in the platform. So now back to parameters. The first parameter is custom comment. It's shown as a description by the open trade. The second parameter is magic number, and that is, as we mentioned before, the unique ID. Then we have here replies existing orders. It says if the existing orders will be replaced instead of deleting. Then you can see here the money management that we are using. In this case, we use fixed lot 0.1. Another parameter is don't trade on weekends. You can set the strategy not to trade on weekends, of course. Then setting of Friday close time, setting of Sunday open time. With these options, we limit the strategy to trade in the concrete time range. Here you can enable or disable exit and the end of the day. If it would be allowed, you would see here true instead of false, and the strategy would exit the open trade at 11:04 p.m. Friday exit time now is set at 10:40 p.m. And here you can limit the time range in case strategy should exit at the end of this time range. Set this parameter to true. Then you will see the parameters that you have to set in trading options. You can limit also maximum trades per day, just as in StrategyQuant. You can set stop loss and profit target maximum and minimum in pips. And then the other parameters that were automatically exported from the StrategyQuant based on your data. So if this market will use a different tick size, you would set it right into this field. But it is not necessary to change it. Then we have here displaying of info panel and settings of modification of open trades. And then there is one important parameter in case you would use strategies with 1 day time frame. It is needed to set up the open bar delay in minutes, and it means that the strategy would be put in the pending order, for example, 5 minutes after midnight. It's just like a specialty of 1 day time frame, when the most of the traders close the trading around midnight, and strategies built for 1 day time frame can have a problem with it. So in case you trade 1 day time frame strategies, you can set here 5 or 10 minutes, for example, when the opening time spreads are quite wide and it is needed to somehow move the order. So in the case of wide spreads, or for example in case of broker's limits. And I'm just going to briefly check everything out. I see that everything is fine, auto trading is allowed for the strategy, and now I can run the strategy. When everything is okay, strategy can, but in the same time doesn't have to show the pending order. Well, and how to actually find out if the strategy is all right? Well, just look at the top right corner and there is a smiling emoji. And when it's smiling, it's okay. And if this emoji would be sad, there is something wrong with the strategy and it's needed to check the log. We will show you how to do that just in a second. And now we are going to show you how to run more strategies in one account. So you would have these strategies in just one terminal. We just showed you setting of one strategy. And now let's switch to the second window where we are going to run our second strategy. So again, drag and drop the strategy to the chart and check the inputs that all the parameters correspond with the settings from StrategyQuant. When everything is fine, just click on OK. And the strategy is running, and as you can see, there is immediately a pending order. But as we mentioned before, it doesn't have to be that fast and you would have to wait for the signal. So if nothing is really happening, don't worry. The important thing is to check the logs and that the emoji in the right top corner is still smiling. When it is smiling, but there are no orders, just wait. In case something will go wrong, the strategy will log it. You can find these logs in the bookmarks journal and experts. In the experts bookmark, there are all the processes that the strategy is making. And in the journal bookmark, you will find information about orders, errors of MetaTrader itself, and so on. In case something would be wrong, you would see it here, written in the red color. You can also filter the log, clicking right mouse on any message from the log, choosing you. There will be this window where you can filter concrete keywords or just errors. You can also set the time range and identify the error immediately, so as fast as possible. And in the same way, you will look for the error also in the other log. And in case you will have any problem and we will ask you for the log, you will find the log under the file, open data folder, MQL4 folder, and experts logs are in the folder MQL4 and logs of MetaTrader in this one. Well, and in case of any problem, you would send us the log and we would be able to identify the problem quickly and properly. And at the end, we recommend to restart the platform so all the settings would be saved and you wouldn't miss anything. And that's all for today. In case of any questions, put them in the discussion forum. Thank you guys for your attention and see you next time.